Hey y'all, so today I'm gonna be showing y'all how I slayed my very first set of acrylic nails in the comforts of my own home, and it only cost me like $10 and a little bit of patience. Keep watching. And I'm gonna show y'all how she did that in tres, dos, uno. Okay, so clearly I'm no professional, but this kit kind of made me feel like I was, therefore I am, and all of you will deal. I got this from Tarjay. It comes with everything you need, the acrylic liquid, the powder, the nail glue, nail tips, I think about 48 of them, the French and the clear kind, so you can use this multiple times, a double-sided Fowler and buffer, and this little cuticle pusher backer thing, whatever they call it. So you want to start with clean clip nails. Just push your cuticles back gently. This allows for a longer, cleaner looking nail bed, and so your acrylic won't lay right on your skin and look a mess. Now you're ready to start applying your tips. Look through and find all the ones that fit your nail beds. You may have to file some of them down to fit you, because I did, but everybody's nail beds are different. Now it's time to glue the tips. So you're gonna fill the well on the back of the tip with just a few drops of glue, and then line the top of your natural nail with the lining that's on the back of the tip. And press it, baby. Press and hold for like 10 seconds, making sure it fully adhered to your nail bed and there's no air bubbles inside the glue. Then you're ready to move on to your next nail. Just repeat those same steps. Fill the well with glue, lay it down on your nail bed, and press it until you're all done and they look a little something like this, or like that lady on Long Island Medium. But I will not be giving the kids Teresa Caputo today, so the tips got to go. Now this part's pretty self-explanatory. Just clip the tips down to your desired length. You need to have figured out, am I going girl next door short or like girl on the corner long? Because once you clip them, you can't go back. I mean, you can, but I mean, ain't nobody got time for that. Me, I'm falling somewhere in between today. I'm not taking too much length off because I need it for the particular shape that I'm doing. So when you're done clipping your nails, you just want to hold your hands side by side just to make sure all the nails are equal in length for the most part, but they're not going to be perfect though. So get over it. Now I'm just shaping the nail. It's not a rocket science, people. So here's how they turned out after I shaped them. They're not perfect, but you know, whatevs. Now for the fun part. Yay, we're like halfway done. Jesus Christ. Okay, start by pouring some of your acrylic liquid into like a little bowl. Be careful with this stuff, y'all, because it's strong and potent. You might need to open a window for some ventilation, because this stuff will have your house smelling just like the nail place up the street. Alright, now you want to start prepping your nails for the acrylic. Just go over each nail with the pink side of the Fowler, just making it a little bit rough so the acrylic will have something to latch on to. Okay, so while we buffing, let's take a second to get into my leopard pajamas though. I know you see them. Yes, they were my grandmother's. Get into them. Okay, so now it's time to lay our acrylic. Yes, lay it for the gods, darling. So just take your acrylic brush and dip it in the acrylic liquid, and then lightly drag it across the top of the acrylic powder until it forms a ball. Place the acrylic kind of where the tip and your real nail bed meet. Then pat it down side to side, making sure it gets all over your nail bed but not on your skin. And after that, just gently brush it all kind of towards the top of the nail, just making sure that the nail is smooth and blended and level. You shouldn't see a harsh line anymore between where the fake nail and your real nail meet. It should just be smooth and natural looking. Kind of like this. Now just repeat those same steps to the rest of your nails. What I am trying to say. So after about 10 minutes, the acrylic should have set and completely dried, but tap on your nail just to make sure it makes a clicking noise. That'll mean it's completely dry, and you can start shaping and buffing your nails one more time before you apply the paint. The time is ours to take, so we should take it. Wake up. Now just paint and rejoice, kindred. You have made it into the promised land of fake nail realness. Okay, so I really didn't plan to do this nail art. It just kind of happened, so I didn't record it, unfortunately. Sorry, y'all. But I will show you what tools I used to do it. This is how my nails started off, but I got bored with them. So I did like this intergalactic hippie design with like aliens and yin-yangs and moons and shit. I used the eraser to get that perfect circle shape on most of my designs. Then I used the cotton ball and this fine tip nail art brush for detailing.
Take me to your leader.
Side note, in case you're wondering why most of my nails are missing, I did them 2 weeks ago, so this part is kind of after the fact. So yeah, before y'all start lighting me up in the comments, I'm gone and dead there, right there.
Now back to your regularly scheduled programming.
For the galaxy nail, I just used a dark polish for the background and a glitter polish for the stars. You could do whatever design you want though, just make sure you let it completely dry and then follow it up with a good top coat. Okay, that's it for real. We done. It's time of dibba dibba dee. That's all, folks. Spirit fingers! Okay, so here's my verdict. To be honest, this kit was everything, y'all. Like, for $10, it pays for itself. You can use it over and over again. If you run out of tips, you can go get you some more or just do an overlay because you're going to have plenty of acrylic left over. I promise you, bro. And it's very well worth the money if you are a do-it-yourselfer and you got a little time on your hands. Okay, so I think my nails turned out real good for a first try, y'all. I got so many compliments on them. They lasted me for about 2 weeks before they started falling off, but I know that's because I'm real hard on my nails, and that's the reason I never really get them done at the shop. So this was a really good alternative for me. Hopefully it'll work out for you too. I hope this video was somewhat helpful to you. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and comment below, y'all. Peace and love.